Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to compare array with linked list. So we will discuss which is better and in which case you can use array or in which case you can use linked list. So basically, I am going to compare these things. First, I will be explaining the use of variable. Then I will tell you why we use static array. Then I will tell you advantages of dynamic array, and then comes linked list, right? So this is basically a path through which you can learn the requirement of linked list, right? So whenever you begin learning programming or you want to write some programs, so you start with a variable. So what is variable? Variable is a memory location where we can store some values, right? So let's say if you want to store one value, so you will declare a variable, right? And you can declare one value into this variable, right? So if you want to perform operation on a particular value, then you can declare a variable. Now your requirement changes. You want to store more than one values. So what you can do? You can simply declare more variables. Like if you want to store three values, so you can declare three variables, A, B, C, or whatever their name will be. So what happens? Three separate memory locations will be there, and at same point of time, you can store values into these three variables. So this is about variables. Now this is the advantage of variable. Now let's discuss about the drawback, so that we will move to array. Let's say you want to store 50 elements. If you want to store 50 elements, so how many variables are required? 50. So is it easy to declare 50 variables? No, because we need to figure out the names, unique names for those variables. Then let's say if you are reading those values using printf scanf, so you need to use format specifier again and again, and then you need to write the variable names. So let's say if you are able to declare 50 variables, then in case of 500 elements, it is impossible to declare 500 variables and manage that program, because 500 variables are very large amount. So this is the problem. Now solution to this problem is array, and we can divide array into two types, like static array and dynamic array. So first I am going to tell you about static array, and then we will discuss about dynamic array, and then finally we will reach to linked list. So now we need to store 50 elements or 500 elements or 5000 elements. So if you want to store these quantities of elements, then instead of declaring separate variables, you can create an array. Now if you want to declare an array, so this will be the same. Int A, and then in square bracket you can mention the size of the array. If you want to store 500 elements, you can declare array like this. So what is the benefit of using array? We have one variable that is capable to store 50 elements altogether. Again, name of variable is A, and this A variable is capable to store 500 values altogether. Right? So now I hope you understood the requirement of array, because variables, one variable can store one value. So if you want to store more than one value, you require that amount of variable. But using of array is reducing number of variables. Through one variable, we can manage n number of elements. So this is the advantage of array, and that too static array. Now you need to understand the difference between static and dynamic. So let's say we declared this array, right? And we mentioned size as 50. And after writing the complete program, when you execute your program, you need to process these 50 elements. So now my question is, while executing the program, can we change the size of this array? Like, can we increase its size or decrease its size? That is not possible. That's why it is static array. So in case of static memory allocation, at the time of program execution, you cannot change the size of memory. So this is the disadvantage of using static array. So here comes the use of dynamic array. So static array, in case of static array, we need to provide size at the time of writing the program, or you can say at the time of compilation. At the time of execution, we cannot change its size. But if you want to decide memory allocation at runtime or execution time, then you can create your array dynamically. So for that, you need to use pointer and malloc function. So now I am going to tell you how you can create dynamic array. So first, to create dynamic array, we need to declare pointer. So let's say I am declaring a pointer p. Right. So at the time of compilation, only p pointer will be available there. Now, to read size of the memory, we need one more variable, that is n. So now you need to read like how many memory allocation are required or how many values user want to store. So for that, you need to read n from user. So you can write scanf %d ampersand n. So the value of n will be provided by the user at runtime. So at runtime, n will be having a particular value. Now you can use a function, that is malloc. So you can write this statement: int asterisk, then malloc size of int multiplied by n. So this statement is responsible for allocating memory at runtime. So here you cannot say what will be the value of n, because it will be provided by the user while program is executing. So let's say n is 5. So 5 blocks will be allocated and the base address will be provided to p. If value of n is 10, so 10 blocks will be allocated and the base address will be provided to p. So this is your dynamic array. So in this case, what will happen? User will decide how many elements a user want to store. So accordingly, on runtime, memory will be allocated and the values will be stored. So I hope you understood all these three things: variable, static array, and dynamic array. So in case of variable, we have limits, like we cannot declare large amount of variables, because we need to decide their names, we need to manage them, so that is difficult. So we have a solution to that problem, is that is static array. But static array is also having a problem, like we cannot decide size of memory at runtime. So we solve that with the help of dynamic array. So user will provide size and then we will be allocating the memory. So now you might be thinking, like, we have dynamic array, then what is the requirement of linked list? So now I need to tell you the drawback of dynamic array, so that you will get to know how we can convert that drawback into advantage with the help of linked list, right? So I am taking this example. So let's say you are executing your program and you enter value of n as 5. And 5 memory blocks will be allocated, and after this you need to store 5 elements, right? But after memory allocation and processing, in between the processing, your requirement again changes. You need 10 memory locations to store the values. So what will happen? You will use another function, that is realloc. So realloc, what realloc does, it reallocate the memory that is allocated by malloc. So what will happen? The existing values will be removed and new block of memory will be allocated, right? Now again, after realloc, your requirement again changes. You want to increase or decrease size again, then again you will realloc, you will use realloc method. So what will happen? Again, memory size will be decided, and accordingly you need to store the values, and the previous values will be erased, and you need to store all the values again and again. So this is a problem here. So now solution to this problem is linked list. So in case of linked list, what happens? If you want to store one value, so one memory block will be allocated. Then if you want to store another value, then another memory block will be allocated. So if you are storing a value, then only memory will be allocated. So So you don't need to decide like how many values you will be storing, right? So let's say you have a value, you will allocate memory and then you will store that value. Then you have another value, you will again allocate memory and then store the value. So this way linked list works, right? So we don't need to read size of memory altogether, right? So the drawback of dynamic array is the advantage of using linked list. So whenever you are facing a problem like you are again and again allocating memory while executing the program, so in that case you can prefer linked list. So now I'm going to tell you how the linked list works and how it occupies memory locations. So it is very easy to understand. So similar to dynamic array, if we talk about linked list, so again we need a pointer. So first I am explaining the linked list structure in a pictorial way, then I will tell you like how you can create a structure for that linked list with the help of C language. So let's say this is the pointer and I am naming it as start, right? And initially it is having none. Now you executed your program and you want to insert a number. So you will implement your program in such a way, like if you are inserting a number, so first you need to allocate a memory block and then you will be inserting a number. Then again, if you want to insert a number, so a new block will be allocated and existing block will not be modified, right? So in new block, you will be storing a new value. So how it happens? So let's say you want to store a number, so a new block will be allocated. It is known as node. Let's say it is node 1 and it is internally divided into two parts. First part is known as info, or you can say it is value. So whatever name you want to give, you can give to this location, and this location will be a pointer to next. So if you want to store a number, so this memory will be allocated and you get store number here. Let's say you want to store 10. So your number will be stored here and this pointer next will be having null because we don't have any more nodes, their values will be stored. So as you create your first memory location, so its base address will be stored in this pointer. So let's say base address of this memory location is 1001. So this value will be stored. So now you can imagine or you can relate why it is linked list, because memory locations are linked with the help of memory addresses. So if you are on this pointer, so through this pointer you can access this address and you can move to this location and you can access this address. Right? Now if you want to store one more value, so you will create one more memory location that will be node 2. So you can imagine like we are creating new location and we are not modifying this location, right? This value will remain as it is. But in case of dynamic array, if we use realloc, so it reallocates whole memory structure, so previous value will be erased and you need to store them again. But that doesn't happen in case of linked list. So node 2 will be divided into two parts. So this will be info and this is pointer to next. Let's say it is storing 20 and the second part will be having null and its base address, let's say 2001, so it will be stored here. So now if you are on start, so you have address 1001, so you can move to this location. If you are on this location, so its second part is having another address, that is 2001, so through this you can move to this. So this way you can create any number of nodes and you can store values as per your requirement, right? Now if you want to delete any particular node, let's say we have one more node, that is node 3. It is having 30, its base address is 3001, which is stored here and it is null. Now this is the insertion process. Let's say you want to delete a particular node, so what will you do? Let's say you want to delete this node. So you can simply erase this and you can put null here. So if this node next part is having null, it means this node is automatically disconnected with this link list. So this way you can easily delete a particular node from the link list. So when you will be deleting or inserting nodes, you don't need to shift all the elements like we do in array. So if we take an example of array, suppose these values are available, and if you want to insert an element between 2 and 3, so you need to shift all the elements and then you can insert the element in array. But in case of linked list, let's say we have this memory. Now if I want to insert any element in between 10 and 20, so what I will do, I will create one more node, that is node number 4. Let's say its base address is 4001. It is having value as 40. So what I will do, I will store this node's base address here and this node's base address here. So now if we traverse this link list, so if we are on start, so we are having address as 1001, so we will move here. Then this node's next part is having address as 4001, so we will directly move here. It is having 2001, so we will go here and then we can move here. So this way you can easily insert any element without moving any other value that is available in the link. And similarly, if you want to delete a particular node, let's say if I want to delete this node from the middle of this link list, so what I can do, I can store this address here and I will be deleting this memory location so that this will be removed from this link list. So 1001 is having 2001 in the next part, so it will be linked with this, and this will be linked with this, and this will be removed from the link. So insertion and deletion is very easy in case of link list because we don't need to shift each and every element like we do in arrays. So this way, I hope now you understood the requirement of variable, then why we move to static array, then why we move to dynamic array, and then why we move to link list. So this way, I hope you understood the whole comparison between all available data structures where we can store values. So basically, all we use to store values. So in some case, memories are located at compilation time. We cannot change those memory locations at runtime. But in some cases, memories are located at execution time. So you can allocate memory as per your requirement. So variable and static arrays are compilation time memory location, whereas dynamic array and link list occupies memory while program is executing and as per the requirement of the user. So this way, I hope you understood the difference between array and link list well. If you want to watch more data structures and algorithms related videos, so you can go to description of this video. You will find links of playlists, so you can follow them to learn more about data structures and algorithms. Thank you for watching this video.